going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. And today we are starting off with Ghostbusters, which came out last Friday. And on Friday, it topped the day with $16.5 million that it made in ticket sales, which is really, really great start for the first day of the weekend. And not just that, the film actually got its own cinema score done as well. And it earned an A-minus cinema score, which is really, really good. That's almost as high as you can get. Like, you know, when you reach that A level, that's amazing. And it is well ahead of the previous film, Ghostbusters, the remake that was done in 2016 by Paul Feig. That only received a cinema score of B+. So, A-minus, really strong cinema score for Ghostbusters. Afterlife, and they actually beat their expectations, I think, for the weekend. Over the weekend, they were expected to make $40 million or more in North America. And throughout the weekend, they actually made $44 million in theatres, which is really good going for them. I haven't actually seen the film myself, so I don't know what it's like. I haven't really watched the trailers or anything. But, It's quite impressive. You know, first weekend is pretty good. But apparently the first weekend is trailing the remake that they did in 2016. That apparently made $46 million in its opening weekend. But I don't know. $44 million with the way things are now is a really, really strong start for this film, I think. And the cinema score clearly says that it hits, you know, with fans in the right places and stuff. So, it's a really solid number, said Paul Bidian? Comscore's senior media analyst. Part of that is the theatrical exclusive release. This shows that this brand is really powerful, even some 37 years after the original became a cultural phenomenon. The weekend's other high-profile offering didn't fare as well. King Richard, the well-reviewed drama starring Will Smith, his father of tennis greats, blah, blah, blah. So, yeah. Over the weekend, it's gotten past a lot of stuff. Because what it's built, Will Smith's thing that he did with King Richard, where he played the father of Venus and Serena Williams, that only made $5.7 million and on its first weekend. But there is tie-ins with this that says, you know, that it isn't everything what you make on the first weekend. And in some respects that is true. It isn't everything that you make the first weekend that defines kind of how things are gonna go. Because for example, the Green Book, which they state in here, in 2018 the Green Book opened on a Thanksgiving weekend to only $5.5 million. But at the end of the award season, it had grossed over $85 million. So, yeah. But I'm not saying that Ghostbusters is not going to make a lot of money. I think this one has the potential of making quite a bit. I wouldn't be surprised if it got beyond what Green Book grossed. I wouldn't be surprised if I don't know. It is weird, actually. It's weird the way cinema releases work. I feel like this is a good start for this film, though. And I'll have to watch it and review it and see how I feel about it myself when I watch it. But that'll be a while, though, because obviously it's going to take ages before it's out of cinemas and stuff, so yeah, but apparently over the weekend, like, what? Ghostbusters came out, that made $44 million. King Richard came out, that made $5.7 million. And that was about it over the weekend. That was the only, like, new ones that came out. So, yeah, for a new film on the weekend, it made quite a bit of money. We're going to move on from this one. We're going to move on to another new story. And that is about Arcane. Arcane is renewed for Season 2 by Netflix. So, yep, there is going to be a Season 2 of Arcane. Which is, you know, I think that's going to excite a lot of people that this is coming, that there's going to be a Season 2 of this series. I haven't watched the first season, but I am going to watch it because I've heard good things about it. But there is going to be a season two. And Hailee Steinfeld, Ella Purnell, and Katie Leung are set to reprise their roles in the sophomore season as V, Jinx, and Caitlin Karaman. Karaman? Respectively, season two is in production. So yeah, this season two is happening, it's going. And apparently season one was like so well received. I know that I was looking on Rotten Tomatoes, and when I was looking on Rotten Tomatoes, it had like a crazy high score of like 100 from people. Like it hit 100 from people, which is absolutely mental to think about, really. Where you get a viewer score of 100. I don't know whether it's still at 100 or not. Yeah. And the final bit of news, which is really, really interesting. Like, super interesting. Like, this shit could be absolutely goddamn phenomenal. Ridley Scott live-action Blade Runner and Alien TV series being developed, pilots written. So, yeah. This is a pretty important one that's coming out soon. Dave's pilots have been written for Blade Runner and the Alien TV series. So speaking with the BBC on Monday, the House of Gucci Halmer suggested the Blade Runner adaptation is being plotted as a 10-episode series. We have already written the pilot for Blade Runner and Bible, so we're already presenting Blade Runner as a TV show. The first 10 hours. Scott also said that Alien was getting a similar treatment. A pilot was being written alongside the Bible, what transpires in the first 8 to 10 hours of the show. So, yeah, there was news of the Alien series, which was apparently last year, and it's set to be on FX. And that's mind-blowing, right? In some ways. I like TV series more than I like films in terms of watching stuff. Especially now, because I feel like TV series have significantly improved. So, yeah. Watching TV series is it's important, right? I don't know. So it's not important, but I feel like it's more of an experience now, right, than before. They've really changed the way it works to increase the production value. Episodes seem to run a bit longer now as well. I think now it's more expected to have a 45-minute, 50-minute episode. Even sometimes an hour or longer for certain episodes, right, and TV series. And I feel like that's a good thing because I know you can have a 10-part TV series that's 10 hours long, each episode's an hour, and it just really stretches out story and gives you an experience and allows you to see every detail and aspect of it. And it allows them to tell their story without the time constraint of a film of trying to cram everything into what a 2.5-hour period. Or into 3 installments that are all 2.5-hour period. When with the TV series, you have that flexibility of saying, okay, we'll do 10 episodes. Each episode will be an hour. And we'll do this, this, and this. And in these episodes, we'll do this part, we'll do this part. And you can really plan it out and develop it better than sort of forcing yourself to be constricted. So I think that's why I like TV series a lot more, because it seems like they're less constricted in what they can do. Because they have that flexibility. And even some TV series, it's not even like it's going to be 10 episodes a season. It's more than that for some, right? So, yeah. I'm excited for this. I'm excited that Ridley Scott's doing this. So, he hadn't previously discussed a Blade Runner TV, so... So, yeah. It's interesting. It's interesting. I want to see where this goes. I want to see what they're going to do with this, what it's going to be about and stuff. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.